Let's now try to bring back some of the details on how images are captured from these cameras and try to get into some representations of how mathematically we can look at all of this. Here we will basically start off with an image that we want to capture, and this is my sensor. As we looked in the image processing and image representations, most of the time we represent an image in this form with X and Y, or columns and rows. Of course, the 3D world has this coordinate axis, Y, up, X, and Z, which could be sometimes, in this case, be perspective as we go down into the scene. So imagine if this is my object in the scene, what would it actually look like in a 3D camera? So to help us kind of get into understanding this kind of concept of a camera model, let's imagine I have an object in this 3D scene. To help us, we will actually unwrap this, and now I'm showing the z-axis. In this way, x and y, so I've kind of turned it around and looking at this scene from this direction, and that basically is the way I'm looking at here. So this is my object, again shown here. Basically, I'm just going to give it some value, x, y, and z, which basically is this point here of this object. We can basically look at all of the values. So x is this, z is this, sorry, z would be this value, x is this value, and y would be how high this object is. Of course, the tracing the ray through, and imagine this to be a pinhole. So this is my pinhole of the camera itself. Ray goes through here. And of course, on the other side, I should be able to now think about where the image would be formed. We'll get an inverted image on that side there. And of course, it's on that side of the x-axis. And this would be the value in the image plane on the sensor. And it's my sensor. This is where the image forms on that side of the camera. So the camera pinhole is here, the sensor is here, 3D scene is here. We know that, of course, the sensor should be at the focal plane. Now, using similar triangles, we can actually start finding out more information about where the values of this would be. The similar triangles basically says that the ratio of xi over f, which is xi over f, should be the same as x naught, which is this value here. So xi is this, and focal length, of course, is this. Similarly, x0 is this, and in place of f, we have the z value here. So xi over f is equal to x naught over z naught. And similarly, for y, we can do the same thing and come up with this equation. We can simplify this to now be able to get the values of xi and yi with this relationship. So as long as I know, of course, how far the object is from a scene and where it is, I should be able to now figure out where the pixel value would be on that image itself. Of course, not all the time do we know these values from the real world, especially just from an image.